Come, let us sing to every nation, great is our God and King. He is the rock of our salvation. Lift up your hearts and sing. So sing, for we are God's people, for He has shown us His ways. He gathers us to His table to partake of His grace. Come, let us sing to every nation, great is our God and King. Great is our God and King.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, strength of those who hope in you, graciously hear our pleas. And since without you mortal frailty can do nothing, grant us always the help of your grace, that in following your commands, we may please you by our resolve and our deeds. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the second book of Chronicles. After the death of Jehoiada, the princes of Judah came and paid homage to King Joash, and the king then listened to them. They forsook the temple of the Lord, the God of their fathers, and began to serve the sacred poles and the idols. And because of this crime of theirs, wrath came upon Judah and Jerusalem. Although prophets were sent to them to convert them to the Lord, the people would not listen to their warnings. Then the Spirit of God possessed Zechariah, son of Jehoiada the priest. He took his stand above the people and said to them, God says, why are you transgressing the Lord's commands so that you cannot prosper? Because you have abandoned the Lord, He has abandoned you. But they conspired against Him, and at the king's order, they stoned Him to death in the court of the Lord's temple. Thus King Joash was unmindful of the devotion shown him by Jehoiada, Zechariah's father, and slew his son. And as Zechariah was dying, he said, may the Lord see and avenge. At the turn of the year, a force of Arameans came up against Joas. They invaded Judah and Jerusalem, did away with all the princes of the people, and sent all their spoil to the king of Damascus. Though the Aramean force came with few men, the Lord surrendered a very large force into their power. Because Judah had abandoned the Lord, the God of their fathers, so punishment was meted out to Joas. After the Arameans had departed from him, leaving him in grievous suffering, his servants conspired against him because of the murder of the son of Jehoiada the priest. He was buried in the city of David, but not in the tombs of the kings. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Forever I will maintain my love for my servant.
Forever I will maintain my love for my servant.
I have made a covenant with my chosen one. I have sworn to David my servant. Forever will I confirm your posterity and establish your throne for all generations.
Forever I will maintain my love for my servant.
Forever I will maintain my kindness toward him, and my covenant with him stands firm. I will make his posterity endure forever, and his throne as the days of heaven.
Forever I will maintain my love for my servant.
If his sons forsake my law and walk not according to my ordinances, if they violate my statutes and keep not my commands.
Forever I will maintain my love for my servant.
I will punish their crime with the rod and their guilt with stripes. Yet my mercy I will not take from him, nor will I belie my faithfulness.
Forever I will maintain my love for my servant. Please all stand.
Alleluia. Jesus Christ became poor, although he was rich, so that by his poverty you might become rich.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "No one can serve two masters. He will either hate one and love the other, or be devoted to one and despise the other. You cannot serve God and mammon. Therefore, I tell you, do not worry about your life, what you will eat or drink, or about your body, what you will wear. Is not life more than food, and the body more than clothing? Look at the birds in the sky. They do not sow or reap. They gather nothing into barns, yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not more important than they? Can any of you, by worrying, add a single moment to your lifespan? Why are you anxious about clothes? Learn from the way of the wildflowers grow. They do not work or spin. But I tell you that not even Solomon, in all his splendor, was clothed like one of them. If God so clothes the grass of the field, which grows today and is thrown into the oven tomorrow, will he not much more provide for you, O you of little faith? So do not worry and say, what are we to eat? Or what are we to drink? Or what are we to wear? All these things the pagans seek. Your heavenly Father knows that you need them all. But seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things will be given you besides. Do not worry about tomorrow. Tomorrow will take care of itself. Sufficient for a day is its own evil. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Siguro swak na swak ho yung ebanghelyo ho sa atin, ano? Bagay minsan masabi natin sapul talaga. Aminin natin minsan mabilis tayong mag-worry o mabagabag. Mabilis tayong mamroblema. Mabilis tayong ma-anxious sa mga bagay-bagay. Ang anxiety can easily take a hold of us. Pero maganda yung paalala sa atin ng Diyos sa ating ebanghelyo ngayon. Sa ating pagbisita dito, sa ating dito sa dambana ni Jesus Nazareno, siya din nagpapaalala sa atin, huwag kang mabagabag, do not worry, do not be anxious of tomorrow. Pero di ba minsan yung pagiging anxious ay iniisip natin agad yung posibleng mangyari. Pwede yung mangyari, pwede yung hindi mangyari, pero nagre-react tayo na para nangyayari na. Iniisip mo, ano yung kakainin ko? Alas 11 pa lang, iniisip mo na yung hapunan mo. At ang dami mo nang iniisip, ang dami mo nang senaryong iniisip, anong pwedeng mangyari? At lahat ng mga iniisip mo, puro masasamang mangyayari. Pero yung nagre-react ka na parang nangyayari na. Kaya mabilis kang pangunahan ng takot, pangamba, at anxiety. Pero magandang paalala sa atin ng Diyos, opte ka lang. Sa kabila ng pag-iisip mo, sa kabila ng pag-worry mo, learn to take a deep breath and relax. Yung magandang gawin natin pag na you feel that anxiety is taking a control of you, on you, learn to take a deep breath. Relax ka muna. Pwede samahan mo ng panalangin. At ang paalala sa atin ng Diyos, huwag ka masyadong mabagabag. Relax ka lang. Kung yung mga ibon nga pinakakain ng Diyos, ikaw pa kaya? Kung yung mga damo ay mas pinararamitan ng Diyos na mas marangya pa raw kay Solomon, ikaw pa kaya? Magandang paalala sa atin ito para lumago tayo sa tiwala natin sa Diyos. Ang paalala sa atin ng Diyos, hindi lang mag-worry. Pero huwag ka mag-alala dahil nagtitiwala ka sa Diyos. Hindi ka nag-aalala dahil alam mo na hindi ka pababayaan ng Diyos. Sa kabila na yung mga problema, sa kabila ng mga iniisip mo at gumugulo sa isip mo, alam mo may Diyos na katulong mo. Alam mo may Diyos sa pagkakatiwalaan mo na pwede mong ihinga ang lahat ng problema mo at kasama kanya na aalis dyan sa pinagdadaanan mo. Kasama kanya at kalakbay kanya para malampasan mo ang pinagdadaanan mo. Learn to trust God all the more when you have problems. When worries, when anxiety takes control of you, learn to trust God all the more. Minsan, ang dami nating gustong sabihin sa Diyos. Ang dami nating gustong ihinga sa Diyos. Pero maganda rin naman na isuko din natin sa Diyos ang mga problema natin. Place your problems at the feet of God. Alam niyo, minsan pag may problema ako, may iniisip ako, lagi kong inaalala yung sulat ho ni San Pedro. Sinasabi niya ho doon, cast your cares to Him for He cares for you. Ibigay mo sa Diyos. Ilatag mo sa Diyos. Huwag mong solohin yan. Ilapag mo ang problema mo sa paanan ng Diyos. At Siya na nangangalaga sa atin. Siya ang Diyos na nagmamalasakit sa atin ay pangangalagaan tayo. Magtiwala lang tayo sa Kanya. Siguro yun yung magandang hingin natin, no? Hingin natin bilang mga deboto, bilang mga peregrino na nagtutungo dito sa dambana ni Jesus sa Sareno, na nais sumumpong ng mukha ng pag-asa sa kabila ng inyong mga problema. Nais tumingin kay Jesus at nais biyayaan ni Jesus ng kanyang pag-asa. Kumapit kay Jesus sa Sareno. Siya na ating pinagkakatiwalaan. Siya na ating pag-asa. At Siya ang gabay natin tungo sa ating paglalakbay. Hindi ito yung pinapangako ni Jesus na pag nagtiwala sa Kanya, worry-free na ang buhay mo. Hindi yung pinapangako ni Jesus na kapag nagtiwala ka sa Kanya ay hindi ka na makakaramdam ho ng anxiety. Pero pag kumapit ka kay Jesus, kahit may worries ka, kahit may panahon na nagiging anxious ka, alam mong kaya mo. Kaya mong harapin dahil nariyan ang Diyos na kapiling mo. Kaya mong harapin ang bawat problema, bawat mga pagsubok mo, kaya mo siyang harapin dahil hindi ka nag-iisa. Kasama mo ang Diyos na pinagkakatiwalaan mo. Wala ka dapat ikabahala o ikapangamba. Amen.
Please all stand.
The gospel calls us to be single-minded in our service of God. May our prayers to the Father express that quality of trust and devotion as we pray. Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That church leaders may devote themselves tirelessly to the furthering of God's kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may realize the need to show care and concern for the poor and the needy. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may live in complete submission to the will of God and never become anxious concerning matters that are not worth worrying about. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick may experience the love of God through the compassion of those who care for life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the faithful departed may share in Christ's victory over death. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father, we trust in you. May we never set our hearts on material things, but on your loving providence. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
For this bread, and as we bring you this wine, bless them, Lord Jesus, feed us now, give us life, send us your Spirit, the source of our lives, and together we will serve you with love.
Please all stand.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
O God, who in the offerings presented here provide for the twofold needs of human nature, nourishing us with food and renewing us with your sacrament, grant, we pray, that the sustenance they provide may not fail us in body or in spirit, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For although you have no need of our praise, yet our thanksgiving is itself your gift. Since our praises add nothing to your greatness, but profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord. And so, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please all kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please all stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Jose our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days. By the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please all kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. To all who will receive the Holy Communion, please say Amen when the priest or lay minister saying Body of Christ, and reverently consume the Body of Christ before leaving at the front of the priest or lay minister. Please be guided accordingly.
Stay with me, Lord, that I may never forget you. Stay with me, Lord, because I'm weak. Stay with me, Lord, for you are my life. Stay with me, Lord, for you are my light. Oh, how I need you, my Jesus, in this night of exile. Stay with me, my Jesus, in the breaking all the bread, the light which disperses all darkness, the voice that sustains me, lay in me joy. Show me your will. Stay with me, Lord, that I may hear your voice and follow you. Stay with me, Lord, for I desire to love you. Stay with me. Night of exile, stay with me, my Jesus, in the breaking of the bread, the light which disperses all darkness, the force that sustains me, the joy of my heart. Stay with me, Lord, that I may ever forget you. Stay with me, Lord, because I'm weak. Stay with me. Stay with me, Lord, for you are my life. Oh, how I need you, my Jesus, in this night of exile. Stay with me, my Jesus, in the breaking of
announcement. Sa darating na June 24, Lunes, dakilang kapistahan ng pagsilang ni San Juan Bautista. Ang oras ng ating mga misa sa araw na iyon ay katulad ng Linggo. At ang ating piyesta mass ay ganap na 12:50 ng tanghali na pamumunuan ng kanyang kabunian Jose Cardinal Advincula, Arsobispo ng Maynila. Ipinagbibigay alam po sa lahat, lalo na sa mga ministry at organization, HDN, mga samahan o grupo ng ating simbahan, na ang ating karakol ay gaganapin sa ikatlo ng hapon na iikot sa paligid ng simbahan at ang maringal na prosesyon ay ganap na ikaapat ng hapon. Ang lahat po ay inaanyayahan sa mga gawang ito ng ating kapistahan. Mabibili pa rin po ang ating opisyal na imahe ni Jesus Nazareno. Ang mga ito po ay mabibili lamang sa ating parish finance office. Ang malilikom po na pondo ay gagamitin sa pagsasaayos ng ating Adoration Chapel at Baptistry. Pagkatapos ng misa, wiwisikan po ang lahat ng banal na tubig. Pinakikiusapan ang lahat na manatili lamang muna sa inyong mga lugar. Tanging sa Quezon Boulevard o Plaza San Juan lamang ang labasan ng lahat. Sumunod po tayo. Maraming salamat po sa inyong pagdalaw at pagsisimba sa Basilica Minor at Pambansang Dambana ni Jesus Nazareno. Please all stand.
Let us pray. After this reception of your Holy Communion, O Lord, foreshadows the union of the faithful in you. So may it bring about unity in your church. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Blessed are you, Lord God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. You have given us your only Son to be our way to you. Make us follow him generously, faithfully and lovingly. Merciful Jesus of Nazareth, you have revealed God's grace and unconditional love for us at the cross. You set your church in this world, from which the true light would shine for all to see. Grant that we who enter this holy shrine may walk in your ways as disciples of justice, peace, mercy, and hope. We offer our prayers for the sick, the oppressed, the youth, and those in need most of your mercy. Hear our humble petitions, bless these religious articles, that they may be fervent in prayer and charity. As we continue our journey as your pilgrim people here on earth, may we set our hearts to the road to heaven, our true home and reward, where you live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Sa Padre Jesus Nazareno, sinasamba ka namin. Inibintuho ka namin, aral mo ang aming buhay at kaligtasan. Nuestro Padre Jesus Nazareno, iligtas mo kami sa kasalanan. Ang krus mong kinamatayan ay sagisag na aming kaligtasan. Nuestro Padre Jesus Nazareno, dinarangal ka namin. Nuestro Padre Jesus Nazareno, ilumalanhati ka namin. Nuestro Padre Jesus Nazareno, dinarangal ka namin.
nuestro Padre Jesús Nazareno, minuno alhan canal.